Good evening, everyone. An ordinance to keep Des Moines sewers from getting clogged with grease is causing some unintended problems for businesses that don't even serve food.
News Channel 8's Marcus McIntosh is live in Beaverdale with our top story. Marcus?
Kevin and Stacy, by all accounts, Cup of Kryptonite was a very successful coffee shop, comic book store on Des Moines' south side. But when that business moved here to Beaverdale, we're told the new regulations made it too expensive to keep part of that business going.
After a decade on the south side of Des Moines, the popular Cup of Kryptonite is in Beaverdale, but will no longer be brewing coffee to sell. Because of the move and the desire to sell coffee, it would fall under the food service requirement calling for the business to have a grease trap or grease interceptor. So it is now just a comic book store.
That seems like an extremely ridiculous law. It's not case by case at all. It's food license requires this, no matter what the food is.
Interceptor. And
Des Moines Public Works Director Bill Still is charged with making sure food service business has the proper grease disposal system.
Coffee houses, an example, use creamers. They could decide they want to do sausage sandwiches, whatever it may be. So our issue is to go in and provide them a mechanism on their side, that is the private side of the system, to keep grease from going into the public side.
A grease interceptor is outside the building and requires enough space to dig up the ground in order to put that in. Cost that could start at $20,000. Michael Leo of Strudelhaus wants to open a small pastry shop. He feels the requirements have prevented him from following his dream.
Now, I understand the city point view. They don't want the oil and grease down the pipes and the sewer lines.
Leo says he found space in the East Village, but cannot afford what he said would be the $40,000 to $60,000 it would have cost to put the grease trap inside the building.
Personally, from my point of view, I think the sewer lines are outdated, and that's part of the reason why we get forced to put that in, so that rolling the cost over to us.
So Leo rents kitchen space with a grease trap on Des Moines' southeast side while still looking for a space for Strudelhaus to call its own.
Now, Kevin, I mentioned these are new requirements. They're actually 5 years old. I want to make that correction. And Michael Leo tells us it would take him 10 years before he could be able to justify the cost of putting in a new grease trap in some business or some space that he chose to rent. But there is also the cost to service those grease traps or grease entrapment systems, and that is a cost as well. Bill Stowe tells us the requirement went into effect, since the requirement went into effect, there's been a big drop in the number of grease clogs that causes backups onto the streets and into the waterways. So, Kevin, back to you.
Marcus, businesses and restaurants that opened before the new requirements went into effect, are they kind of grandfathered into this or what?
Yes, they are, Kevin, but there are some circumstances where they would be forced to make a change, and that would mean those businesses would change their plumbing, would have some kind of new construction or renovations that cost $50,000 or more, so they would be grandfathered in up until those 3 points.
Marcus, thank you.